in a stable orbit. You should be perfectly fine.
Guys, there seems to be a bit of a problem. Hello?
Come in, Martinez.
Good guy!
Alright, so I've been here for 3 hours. Are you guys gonna let me back in yet?
Yeah, maybe we can go for a little bit more data out there. See you in a little bit.
Black holes. You probably think of them as huge, empty spaces sucking in everything it comes into contact with, like a really big vacuum cleaner. And though black holes are undoubtedly interesting, this is not what black holes do. Everything you know about black holes, though, isn't actually wrong. It's just that we imagine black holes as massive vacuum cleaners that will swallow you whole if you're within so much as 10 light years of one. But if a black hole suddenly replaced the sun, gravitationally, nothing would really happen. As long as the black hole replacing the sun is the same mass as the sun, nothing would really happen, gravitationally at least. We'd be a frozen hellhole, but gravitationally nothing would happen, we'd be fine. Imagine crushing the Earth to something around the size of a golf ball. That's basically what black holes are. However, everything you know about black holes would still happen if you got too close to one, even if you were still outside the event horizon. If you got close enough to a black hole, gravitational differences between your head and feet would be multiplied by the thousands or millions, and this results in spaghettification, which means you would slowly crash into the black hole, resulting in redshifting, time dilation, etc. So technically, the beginning scene is actually true, given how close Martinez is to black hole. What about light, though? Don't black holes suck in light? If light can't escape, how could your ship? Well, light cannot escape the event horizon, which is what makes black holes so dark. And black holes do cause gravitational lensing, as see here, but so do large galaxies. In fact, in this photo, that's not a black hole curving this galaxy. That's another galaxy curving this galaxy. Galaxies have a lot of gravity too, and they can distort the light of anything moving behind them easily, just as easily as a black hole can do. Remember the movie Interstellar, for those of you who have seen it, where the crew's trying to get back to the wormhole via a gravitational assist from Gargantua? Well, not only is this scene amazing to watch, that would actually be entirely plausible. Endurance would just have to be traveling a lot faster than it would orbiting a normal, less dense object. However, if you weren't traveling fast enough, then you would experience the normal suck tangential black hole experience, because you're not traveling fast enough to orbit the black hole, therefore you would fall into the event horizon. This is also how we know about black holes at all, as light can't leave them, so they're not very easily detectable on their own. But we've seen stars orbiting what seems to be nothing, but it's actually, yes, you guessed it, a black hole. And spoiler alert, the stars are fine. Thank you for watching this video. Please be sure to give it a like, comment, and share it. If you want to learn even more about this, please be sure to watch episode 33 of Crash Course Astronomy. It actually really helped in the making this video. But if you want to watch more KhAnubis Productions, please be sure to subscribe for more videos every Sunday. Or ring that bell, I guess I should now say. Either way, see you next Sunday.